Hey everyone, Patrick CK here. Today I'm tackling something I've noticed several people, including myself, struggling with after getting a pair of XREAL AR glasses. And that's simply getting them connected to a Windows desktop PC. In this video, I'll walk you through exactly what you need and provide a quick overview of the Nebula app from XREAL so you can make the most of your AR glasses once they're connected to your PC. I bought the first generation XREAL Air glasses about a year ago, thinking I could use them as an alternative to buying more monitors for a 3-monitor setup for maximum productivity. However, I quickly faced the challenge of figuring out how to connect them to my PC. After searching and coming across various videos, some of which provided incorrect advice, like recommending an HDMI to USB-C cable, I finally found the right solution. The key thing to know about XREAL glasses, including the newer models, is that they rely on the DisplayPort protocol for their display connection. This means you'll need a DisplayPort to USB-C cable. But it doesn't stop there. These glasses also require a separate power source, so you'll need a cable with an additional USB-A adapter to supply that power. Thankfully, several options are available, and I found one that has worked perfectly for me ever since. It's officially called a DisplayPort to USB-C with USB-A power adapter cable. It's made by one of those generic brands with a random Scrabble-like name you find on Amazon. But the one I purchased is sturdy, well-made, and feels like a quality product, at least as far as products from no-name companies go. Most importantly, it's been reliable and works great for my setup. We can see that it does have what we need, a USB-A plug and cable for power, feeding into the DisplayPort plug, which then leads to the USB-C that goes into the glasses. It is a thick cable, so cable managing it from the back of a computer to the glasses can be a bit awkward, but at 6.6 feet long, you should have enough slack to make it work for most setups. Link to this cable will be in the description. Once you have the cable, start by plugging the DisplayPort end into your GPU. Next, connect the USB-A end into a powered port on your motherboard. It's important to use a powered port. Most simple USB hubs won't work, as they may not provide enough power. Using a port on your motherboard ensures your XREAL glasses get all the power they need. Finally, plug the USB-C end into your XREAL glasses. Your PC should automatically recognize the glasses as a display and treat them based on your current display settings. For me, it simply adds the glasses as my third monitor. If all you're looking for is a secondary display, you're good to go. But if you want to explore the full AR experience, you'll need to download the Nebula app. For PC, the app is still technically in beta, and it has been for over a year, but it's available for download and installation. I'll include a link where you can find it. Fortunately, the app was recently updated to version 0.8 as of January 2025. And even if the version I link becomes outdated, it will automatically update the first time you launch it. Depending on when you install it and the model of your glasses, the app may also update your glasses firmware. Once everything is installed, updated, and connected, you'll have the option to customize your virtual desktop layout. I prefer the 3-monitor setup because it makes snapping windows to the side screens much easier than working with a single ultra-wide monitor. However, the choice is entirely up to you. From there, you can set the refresh rate and start using your AR space. The final setup screen provides a simple yet effective interface to configure your layout and optimize your AR experience. I'll do a quick overview of these options. I don't have a capture card, so it might be a little difficult to demonstrate how the options affect your view, but I'll try. Apologies for the mismatched refresh rates causing the diagonal bands on the screen. Obviously, you won't see these in your glasses. The very first button allows you to reset the position lock of the virtual desktop in the AR space. If you're not seeing anything when you first launch the virtual desktop, make sure to click this button so that it positions it where you're currently looking. After that, you can change your virtual desktop layout again. The distance setting adjusts how far the virtual screens appear from your point of view, while size lets you scale the screen's dimensions independently of the distance. Curve determines how much the virtual screens wrap around you, creating a more or less immersive experience. And gap controls the space between multiple virtual screens, helping you customize your setup to your preference. There are a few issues with the Nebula app as it stands. The most noticeable is the significant screen tearing whenever you move your head, which makes it seem like the app isn't fully optimized yet. I'm using a 3080, but unfortunately, I haven't been able to resolve this issue either through the Nebula settings or the NVIDIA control panel. Please let me know if anyone has found a fix for this. Another problem is that unlike physical monitors, where you can still see your screens in your peripheral vision, the limited field of view of the glasses doesn't allow for that kind of perception. The only way to achieve this is to zoom the screens out fairly far, which doesn't work well for me since I don't have the best eyesight. Lastly, there's an issue with the audio. When you first launch the AR space, the audio output switches to the speakers on the glasses instead of your default audio option. To fix this, you'll need to go into your sound settings and manually change it back. While the speakers on the glasses are decent, they're not as good as the audio setup I typically use with my PC. Your mileage may vary. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, please let me know. If you found the content useful, leave a like and subscribe. Links to everything I mentioned will be in the description. Until next time, this has been Patrick CK. Goodbye.